All this talk of getting old, it's getting me down, my love, like a cat in a bag waiting to drown. This time I'm coming down, and I hope you're thinking of me as you lay down on your side. Now the trucks don't work, they just make you worse, but I know I'll see your face again. Now the trucks don't work, they just make you worse, but I know I'll see your face again. But I know I'm on the losing streak as I pass down my old street. And if you want,
ask you a few questions?
Oh, of course, go ahead.
So, how long have you been a school counselor?
Well, I've been a school counselor for 15 years, give or take a year.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Has the issue of drugs ever come up?
Oh, yes. Every day I get high schoolers coming in to me for advice for drugs.
And what do you think was the most memorable event that happened? Did anything go wrong?
Well, there was this one boy named Damien.
Hey.
Oh, hi! How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Okay, so let's start off. What's your name?
I'm Damien.
Okay, that's a good start. Why are you here?
Well, my teacher told me to come and see you because she said I need someone to talk to.
Oh, okay. So, is there anything that you want to talk about?
Well, not really. I mean...
Okay, so the first meeting was all right. He wasn't very talkative, but he was able to talk about what he liked to do, which is a good start.
Hey, here I am.
Hi,
again.
Damien. Nice to see you again. Okay.
You're sworn to secrecy, right?
Oh yeah, of course. Anything said in this room stays in this room.
Cool. Well, then I'll tell you a little secret. So, I was with my friends the other day, and they were doing drugs, heroin. And they convinced me to have a try, and it was great, you know. It made me feel great, helped me fit in with friends, and it seemed to wash away all my worries.
The second meeting, I was a little worried about him because I thought he would get totally into drugs, and I mean, I've experienced, I've seen many people go to rehab, and I got kind of worried about him. Weeks.
Hey.
Hi, Damien.
Sorry, I've been gone for a few weeks, but I was in jail. I had stolen a laptop from Walmart, and they caught me. But I wasn't going to use the laptop. I was just going to sell it because I needed money for my drugs and the medication for my liver. My mom also caught me stealing from her purse, which didn't end well.
Never does. And the next day... Hi, Damien.
Hey. My parents kicked me out of the house because I wouldn't stop doing drugs. They said I wasn't like I used to be anymore. So now I live on the streets, and... that pretty much convinced me to try to stop taking drugs. Well, just trying to stop made me feel even worse.
I've seen this many times before. It's called withdrawal symptoms. I had hadn't seen Damien in what felt like months, and the headmaster later told me that he died from a blood clot in his head from heroin abuse.
Unfortunately, Miss Schwarzenegger was unable to carry on with the interviewing, so we're going to go straight to the conclusion.
So, do you see how one wrong choice can affect a person's whole life? None of these stories ended well today. And if you think that you're immune to addiction, you are wrong. Nobody can escape it. This is Bobby Pumpernickel, signing off for BASE, CNN, LOL, FLL, FML, N.
God gave me the sunshine, then showed me my lifeline. I was told it was all mine, then I got laid on a ley line. What a day, and your Jesus really died for me. And then Jesus really tried for me. UK and entropy, I feel like it's for me. Wanna feed up the energy, love living like a deity. One day, and your Jesus really died for me. And that's the way it's gonna be. All we've ever wanted is to look good naked. Hope that someone can take it.
No, it's not. Wait, how is that a draw
symptom? I thought you were going to say something.
Unfortunately, Miss Schwarzenegger was unable to carry on with the interviewing. Stop smiling at the camera, you're making...